Welcome to the second derivative test. The goal of this video is to use the second derivative test to determine relative extrema. Now, this presentation assumes you've already watched the video entitled Concavity. If you haven't, you might want to do so. So here's how we're going to use the second derivative test to find relative extrema. If f is some function with a critical value c, remember we find the critical values by setting the derivative equal to 0 or finding where the first derivative does not exist. Now if we take this critical value and sub it into the second derivative, remember the second derivative tells us concavity. So if the second derivative evaluated at c is greater than 0 or positive, then f of c is a relative minimum. Remember, if the second derivative is positive, the function is concave up. Therefore, our critical value would represent the location of a minimum, and the y value of this point would be the relative minimum. And if we take the critical number and sub it into the second derivative, and it's less than 0 or negative, that means that the function will be concave down. And if the function is concave down at a critical value, that means at that value of c would have a high point, so f of c would be a relative maximum. So it's going to be a lot less work to finding relative extrema using the second derivative than the first derivative. The only drawback is that sometimes the test fails. If the second derivative evaluated at the critical value is equal to 0, the test fails, and we have to revert back to the first derivative test. So let's kind of summarize the procedure for finding relative extrema using the second derivative. Step 1, we'll find the critical values of the function by determining where the first derivative is equal to 0 or does not exist. Step 2, we'll find the corresponding y values of the critical values. Step 3, we'll find the second derivative and determine the sign of the second derivative at the critical values. And as just stated, if the second derivative is positive or greater than 0, we have a relative minimum. And if the second derivative is less than 0 or negative, then there is a relative maximum. And the test fails if the second derivative is equal to 0. Let's go ahead and give it a try. So we want to use the second derivative test to find all relative extrema. So we're going to first find the critical values by finding the first derivative. There are no values where this first derivative does not exist, but there are values where it's going to equal 0. This is factorable. So our critical values are x equals 0 and x equals 2. These would be the x-coordinates of the two points we're going to consider for a relative max or min. Next, we need to find the corresponding y-values to these points on the function. Let's go ahead and use the graphing calculator to do this. You can see here I've already typed the original function into y1, so let's use the table feature to find the y values at x equals 0 and x equals 2. So it looks like one point is 0, negative 4, and the other one is 2, 0. Next, we want to find the second derivative and then determine the sign at these critical values. So let's go ahead and find the second derivative. Well, here's the first derivative. So the second derivative would be equal to negative 6x plus 6. So we'll evaluate these by hand. It's pretty straightforward. So here we would have negative 6 times 0 plus 6. This will be a positive value. So let's record the sign of the second derivative. Next, we need to evaluate the second derivative at x equals 2. Again, we don't care about the specific value. We just care about the sign. This would be negative 12 plus 6. The result would be negative. So our conclusion here is the function would be concave up at this point. So if it's concave up, we could conclude that we would have a relative minimum. So let's go ahead and record that. The relative minimum will be the y value. So the relative minimum is equal to negative 4 at x equals 0. On this interval, the second derivative is negative, so it's concave down. So if it's concave down, it would look like this. So we should be able to tell that that means we're going to have a relative maximum. So we would state that our relative maximum is equal to 0, the y value, when x is equal to 2. So as you can see, it's a lot less work than using the first derivative test to determine relative extrema. Let's go ahead and verify this with a graph. Here's our relative minimum, or our low point that we found. Here's our relative maximum, or the high point that we found. So our work looks good. Let's go ahead and try one more example. This one's a little more involved. Step one, of course, we're going to find the first derivative and set it equal to 0. So we'd have negative 15x to the fourth plus 15x squared. Again, this exists over all reals, so the only way we're going to find our critical value is to set it equal to 0 and factor. It's a difference of squares. So we have three critical values, often called critical numbers. We have x equals 0, x equals negative 1, x equals positive 1. These will be the x-coordinates of the three points we'll consider for relative max and min. So to find the y-coordinates of these points, we'll use the graphing calculator. We'll type the original function into the graphing calculator and use the table feature again. Now I've already typed it into y2, so when we go to the table, we'll just look at the y2 column. Again, our x values are 0, negative 1, and 1. So it looks like we have 0, 0, negative 1, negative 2, and 1, 2. Next, we need to find the second derivative so we can determine the sign of the second derivative at these points. So if here's our first derivative, our second derivative would equal negative 60x cubed plus 30x. So we need to determine the sign of the second derivative at x equals 0, at x equals negative 1, and at x equals positive 1. So let's go back to the graphing calculator and type in our second derivative, and go back to the table. So at 0, second derivative is equal to 0. Remember, that tells us the test fails. At negative 1, the second derivative is positive, and at positive 1, it's negative. So let's record this information. X equals negative 1, it was positive. At x equals positive 1, it was negative. So here we record that information in the table. Let's draw our conclusion. Here the test fails. Here it's concave up. So if it's concave up, we would have a relative minimum of negative 2. Let's go ahead and write that in. Relative minimum of negative 2 at x equals negative 1. And on this last one, it's negative. On this last one, the second derivative is negative, so it's concave downward. So if it's concave downward, it would look like this. So we can tell we'd have a high point or a relative maximum. And so our relative max would be equal to 2 at x equals 1. Now we are supposed to go back and use the first derivative to analyze this case more carefully. Let's go ahead and just take a look at the graph and see what we can determine. So here's our relative minimum that we found. Here's our relative maximum. Here's the point that failed the test, and you can see this is not a relative max or a relative min. To the left of this point, the function is increasing, and it's also increasing to the right. So in fact, we do not have a relative extrema at the point 0, 0. I hope that helps explain how you can use a second derivative test to find relative extrema. Thank you for watching.